For more on Lithuania's big step towards energy security, I'm joined by the Lithuanian ambassador to the United States, Ambassador Zygimantas Pavilionis. Welcome to Biz Asia America. Let me first get your reaction to this deal in the Ukraine between Russia, Kiev. This has been a long time in the making, and a lot of people thought it may happen, it may not happen. Your reaction?
Well, details should still come from Brussels, and we should analyze it. But before it comes, I will make it through three little principles. I think they unite China, Lithuania, and America. You know, well, basketball has nothing to do with it, but, you know, it's something that unites us all. Our coach Kozlauskas, who's been coaching national team. But, you know, some other things, maybe they are related to the deal. Market and rules. You know, we believe in market in Lithuania. You have that wonderful picture here. It's our actual regasification unit, the first floating terminal that arrived from South Korea recently, called Independence. And this is how we create market, energy market in Lithuania. Before, we've been very dependent on Russia. We've been end users. And we thought, market works with Russia. We sold some of the networks to Russia. And finally, we ended paying the highest price in Europe, more than Ukrainians for sure. Whenever this ship arrived, actually it's inaugurated on Monday, we pay 30% less already.
Okay, let me just pause for a moment and explain to our audience. So this ship is going to allow basically natural gas to be offshored into Lithuania. Yeah. And this oil, natural gas is coming from Norway. And you're saying you're paying 30% less, correct?
Yes. And the problem, and actually the beauty of it, that Russia cut the price, because Russians they are afraid of markets, it seems. And if you don't have alternatives, you pay the highest price. This is what we learned. And looking to Ukrainian example, I think, look, this is a short kind of term survival kit. They have it for the winter, but if they want to be seriously surviving, well, not only the winter, but the whole decade or so, they have to think energy efficiency, they have to think alternatives, they have to think connections to Europe, they have to be part of European market.
But in your case, Russia is still going to be a provider of natural gas. Your contract, as I understand it, is going to be up in the summer of next year. So my question to you is, do you intend to extend that contract or renew that gas contract with Gazprom?
Well, we will renegotiate it. We are negotiating it. But the beauty of the current situation that we are already paying the market price instead of paying the political price that we've been paying for decades. And this is what we want. That's why I'm like ambassador here in Washington. That's why actually I'm lobbying hard the Congress to expedite the LNG exports as much as possible from the Hill. And not only LNG, actually oil exports. We have the ban on the Hill. If we create those energy markets, we then all survive according to the market.
Can I ask you about the economy there? Your friends, Estonia, Lithuania, I mean, you have a group of countries, none of them are huge, like Russia. Then you have, of course, the situation in Ukraine. How much has that conflict impacted your country and your neighbors?
Well, this is what I wanted to say also from the beginning. It's not only basketball market, but also rules. You know, we like rules that are transparent and clear. Unfortunately, with recent behavior of Russia, we see that rules that our grandfathers created after the Second World War, with China being in Security Council, they are disappearing. We have a revisionist power who are trying to destroy very important rules like inviolability of borders, like citizenship. And instead, they promote something that we learned from the past, ethnicity criteria, you know, superiority of Russian nations. So I think while, by the way, using energy weapons, while extracting those very high prices, monopoly prices from neighbors.
You want to pay market prices. You don't want to be held hostage, basically, by prices. Let me shift gears very slightly here because I only have another minute. You have been invited into the EU. You are the 19th country in the Eurozone, essentially. Are you worried that there might be punishment from Russia? Because this is exactly what happened with Ukraine when Ukraine started to lean towards Europe.
Well, the more Russia was punishing us, the more business was going to the West. We, as Lithuania, were the champion of getting the benefit of a membership in EU. you just compare the data recently announced in Economist that, you know, our GDP before accession was 32% of EU average. Today it's 70.
But are the people of Lithuania fearful of potential punishment?
Yes, of course. Because if you have a player that violates the civilized rules that we create after the Second World War, we should all be kind of afraid, because it's actually ruining the rules we live in. And we should all worry about the borders. We should all worry about minorities. Because if you go back to the examples of actually that Hitler was using in international politics, we all have to be very worried, including in China.
Okay. Well, certainly if you're going to use those words, that's a very different story. Ambassador Zygi Pavilionis, thank you very much for spending time with us on this very big story.